I'm sorry it's so late.
Miss Carr.
No, please. I'm Judy.
Do you think that this film will change the way people view Judy Garland?
It's hard not to appreciate how extraordinary she is when you recognize what challenges she had to overcome in order to continue performing.
As her life got harder, the funnier she became. You know, she was like a comedian who's been through lots of terrible experiences and keeps coming back.
I'm very sorry, but your suite has been released.
What do you mean, released? Where exactly has it gone?
Your account was in arrears.
She's influenced generations.
Oh, my goodness.
But, you know, as we go forward, entertainment is sort of bespoke now, isn't it? And so it's not just a given that we're going to share the same heroes. And it's wonderful to have an opportunity to acknowledge how important she is and just how special an entertainer she was. So that folks who weren't considering, she did more than The Wizard of Oz. Wait, she had all of those films squeezed into that period of time. Wait, she was the greatest live performer of all time. Wait, she was so special. She was iconic. She was important.
And a great screen actress as well as being a singer.
One of the great actresses. I mean, what you can tell as we talk about it.
We're both enthusiasts.
Yeah, that, and we love the opportunity to be part of this experience for all those reasons.
Clang, clang, clang with the trolley.
Mama, please don't go to sleep now.
No, leave the other ones.
Zing, zing, zing.
The kids need a home, Judy.
I know what kids need. They need their mother.
And why was Renee the right person for the part?
I think because you sort of fall in love with her. You know, she has this quality that is, you know, like a bit like Tom Hanks has in a way, this sort of like, people feel they know those sort of actors. Very rare. It's like a movie star quality. And I think Judy Garland had that. Like, people talk about her as though she's in their family in terms of how much they sort of want to look after her. And I think Renee has that a bit.
I need to be with my children.
I would very much like to stay.
She was also, I knew she was like a brave performer because in England, when she did Bridget Jones, that was quite controversial, an American actress coming over here to do an English part. And she won that project. And I felt like she'd have the courage to take on like something as daunting as Judy Garland.
What?
Room service.
I didn't order anything. It's the first sleep I've gotten in weeks and you woke me up.
There's a man under the trolley.
What?
Did you bring it home with you, like at the dinner table? Did you just continue talking like Judy, like Daniel Day-Lewis did with Lincoln, or?
Oh, sure, but just out of habit, because you do it all the time, and there was no dinner table. No, we worked right through that.
Yeah.
You're running, and then you get home, and I'm very greedy, so I don't want to stop. I don't want to. I want to keep digging, and make sure that I'm not forgetting something that that could be incredibly fun.
We'd had this thing where we'd play stuff through her headphones and she had certain phrases that she'd always say before each take just to get the voice in the right place from Garland's own voice. But you know, it's not an impression, it's sort of also, it's like a portrait rather than a photograph.
Well, when I met her, she was, I wasn't sure whether I was meeting Judy or Renee, so it's not like she was saying, hi, I'm Judy, but I went on to set talking about kind of living it. You can't help it after a while. So she was in makeup with the teeth in costume halfway through a scene, and the person I met, I now realize, was like half of each.
And the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true.